Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, acid, bases and salt, we were talking about some of the questions which is related to that of the common salt. We have seen what is baking soda, what is the use of a baking soda, how can we convert the baking soda into baking powder, and what are the different uses of that of the baking powder, how it help in making the cake more fluffy and soft. As well as we have also understood about that of the washing soda. So we have seen that what is a washing soda, what is the formula of a washing soda, as well as what is the physical and chemical properties of the washing soda. Now let us see what is the uses of the sodium carbonate of washing soda. What is the use of washing soda, washing soda or sodium carbonate? What is the use of the washing soda or sodium carbonate? So let us start with the uses. So if you look at the first use here, so it is used for softening of the hard water. So we have seen that how can we soft that of the permanent hardness of the water by adding the sodium carbonate into it. Okay, so first one, it is used for softening of hard water, softening of hard water. Second one, it is used for the cleansing in a domestic purpose. So it is used as a cleansing agent for domestic purpose. Then it is used in manufacturing of the paper. So used in manufacture of paper. Okay, so it is used in manufacturing that of the paper, students. As well as sodium carbonate is used in the manufacture of caustic soda, it is used to manufacture caustic soda, caustic soda, then borax, comma, borax, comma, glass. It is also used in the manufacture of a glass. Then water glass, water glass and soap. So it is used to manufacture caustic soda, borax, glass, water glass and soap. Okay, this is what, these are some of the uses of the sodium carbonate, which we also called as a washing soap. Now, moving on, and we will see what do we understand by the bleaching powder. What is and how is it prepared? And how is it prepared? Okay, so bleaching powder is what? It is what? It is calcium oxychloride is a bleaching powder, and it is written as a CaOCl2. How it will be prepared, student? So it is what? It can be prepared by passing the chlorine gas to that of the bleaching powder. We will get, by passing chlorine to that of the calcium hydroxide, we will get bleaching powder. So we can write here that bleaching powder is called as calcium oxychloride. Calcium oxychloride, and it will be written as CaOCl2 is what? That is the formula of that of the calcium oxychloride. Okay, now moving on. And okay, so there are some other mixture is there in that of the calcium oxychloride, and or we can say that bleaching powder is a calcium oxychloride, but some mixture is also involved in it, which can be written with that of the calcium compound like CaOCl whole twice or CaOH whole twice. Calcium oxychloride, its formula is CaOCl2, but there are some other calcium compounds are also involved, sometimes involved with it, and that can be CaOCl whole twice, CaCl2.H2O and CaOH whole twice. This is what, student, this is the bleaching powder. How bleaching powder is manufactured? Obviously, when we pass the chlorine gas through that of the calcium hydroxide, then there is a formation of a calcium oxychloride. CaOCl2, this will give H2O also. Okay, calcium oxychloride and calcium hydroxide. Okay, this is the preparation. Now write the properties of that of the bleaching powder, properties and uses. What are the properties and uses of bleaching powder? Properties and uses of bleaching powder. So let us start with that of the properties, students. So what can be the properties, student? First of all, when you look at the physical property, it is what? It is yellowish white color powder which gave a very strong smell of the chlorine gas, obviously because of the presence of the chlorine into it. Okay, so it is a yellowish white powder. Yellowish white powder which gives a strong smell of chlorine gas. So it is a yellowish white which gives a strong smell of a chlorine gas. What is the reason behind it? It is because in atmosphere it reacts with the carbon dioxide. It reacts with CO2 to release Cl2 gas. So it is a yellowish white powder which gives a strong smell of a chlorine gas. So basically, what happened? Why it used to release the chlorine gas? Because when this bleaching powder is exposed to that of the atmosphere, to the air, it will react with the carbon dioxide which is present in the air, and ultimately it releases the chlorine gas. This is because we can detect or we can smell the strong smell of a chlorine gas, student. Okay. So basically, what will be the reaction here? So this Cl2. This react with the carbon dioxide then there is a formation of a CaCO3 plus Cl2. So when it react with the carbon dioxide, calcium carbonate is formed and chlorine gas is released. Okay, now what happened in the other, when it reacts with the dilute sulfuric acid, then there is a formation of a calcium sulfate, hydrochloric acid will be formed, and hypochlorous acid will be formed here, students. So this is the second property. So we can write here that when it reacts with the H2SO4, then formation of a hypochlorous acid occur.
chlorous acid
occurs. How? The reaction will be
CaOCl2
when it will react with H2SO4. Then there will be the formation of a
CaSO4 plus HCl
plus
HClO. CaSO4 plus HCl plus HClO.
Okay, so this will be formed when calcium oxychloride will react with sulfuric acid. What happen afterward? This hydrochlorous, it again decomposes to form the hydrochloric acid and nascent oxygen. Decomposes to hydrochloric acid and nascent oxygen
Let us see how.
So this HClO, it will decomposes to form HCl+. Okay, this is nascent oxygen. Okay, it will be called as a nascent oxygen. Okay, so this is for student. Now, what is the role of this nascent oxygen which is produced into that, in that of the bleaching powder? So basically its role, it helps in decolorizing. Okay, so it basically oxidizes to that of the colored substances to colorless, and it is because of that whenever we use the bleach, it makes the thing, it makes the material colorless. Okay, so we can say here that what is the role of this nascent oxygen? It oxidizes color to colorless substance. It basically oxidizes color to colorless substance. Okay. Now see here, what are the uses of the bleaching powder? So see here the first one. The first use here, it is used in laundry. To bleach washed cloth. Then it is used to disinfectant water. Disinfect water.
You know that it is helping
cleaning the water. Then it is used in manufacture of a chloroform.
Used
to manufacture chloroform. Okay, so it is also used to manufacture chloroform. It is also used to bleach linen, it is used to bleach cotton as well as that of the paper. So
used to bleach
linen
cotton and
paper. Okay, so used to bleach linen, cotton and paper. As well as it is used as an oxidizing agent in number of the industries. Okay, so this is what student, this is the bleaching powder, properties of bleaching powder as well as uses of the bleaching powder. Okay. Question is VO, that is why does bleaching powder not dissolve completely in water. Why bleaching powder does not get dissolved in water completely? So it is because when it reacts with the water, it forms the calcium hydroxide, which is basically insoluble in the water. So let us see the reaction here. So when bleaching powder reacts with the water, calcium hydroxide is formed. which is insoluble in water. What will be the reaction, students? So reaction will be calcium chloride, CaOCl2. It will be CaOCl2. When this will react with the water, H2O, then there will be formation of a calcium hydroxide plus water, that is H2O. Calcium oxychloride, which is a bleaching powder, when react with the water, then formation of a calcium hydroxide plus water. This is what? Insoluble in water. That is why bleaching powder do not dissolve completely in water.